Hello and welcome to a new video in the series Verge3D for Blender Basics. In this part of the tutorial, we'll cover customizing our Swiss Army knife product with materials. First of all, we should create more materials that the user could select in the configurator. In Blender, let's switch to shading workspace. Enable viewport rendering. Let's add a very simple object, say icosphere, that will serve as swatch for another material. Place it somewhere beneath the knife and apply scale, just in case. Now let's set up a new material. Name it carbon. And drag some textures copied from the starter files to become nodes. Material setup was formally explained in the part 3, so we'll do this very quickly. From the original material, let's copy the group of nodes responsible for ambient occlusion and paste it to our new material. These are an important thing about swapping materials that we should elaborate. The swatch object from which material is taken must have the same structure as the target object. For example, the object to which we want to transfer a material can have multiple UV layers. It can have shape keys. Or it can be skinned with an armature. If so, we must reproduce these UV layers, shape keys or armature, on the source object as well. Therefore, we should reproduce these two UVs on the swatch object, giving them the same names and ordering. We should do it A to make the material work correctly and B to prevent breaking something on the target object. For example, if the target object has skeletal animation while the swatch object has not, applying material may break this animation. In our case, we only need to reproduce two UV layers on the swatch object. So we can just add another UV and rename them accordingly. Name the first one Texture and the second one AO, just like in the target object. And select the right UVs in the nodes of the new material. We are basically done with the carbon material. Let's name our swatch object accordingly, carbon matte. Let's proceed with material options. Just duplicate the sphere, create another material and name it wood. Drag all the textures which we copied from the starter pack to become nodes. There is no metallic map in this case. Just make sure that the value for metallic in our material is zero, because wood is now metal. Let's copy the nodes related to ambient occlusion. Everything looks great. Let's name the second sphere wood matte. Finally, let's duplicate the sphere one more time and assign the existing plastic material to it. Rename the sphere accordingly. We now have all three materials on our swatches, making sure that none of them is missing. Let's put all three swatch objects to a new collection, Materials. And disable rendering for this collection to make this object invisible in the app. Now export to Verge3D. Let's run the puzzles editor to make use of the swatches we just prepared. Remember, in part 5, we created HTML buttons on the right panel, and now we'll be using them to assign materials. Drag out the HTML event puzzle and select click. The ID for it we assigned previously in Webflow, carbon button. Also check in parent doc. In case you forgot what IDs were assigned to the buttons, you can run the app and hit F12 on your keyboard to open the browser console. Then click this arrow button and point to the HTML element you are interested in. It will show the code for this element that will include its ID. As you can see, the element's ID is actually carbon button, so we did everything right. Let's make the configurator work. Place the puzzle assigned material. Also add a material selector. Select our carbon material. And we'll be assigning this material to the knife cover, which consists of two objects. Front cover and back cover. To assign the material to both these objects at the same time, we can use a list puzzle. We need just two slots to which we insert these two object selectors. Now insert this list to the object slot. Save and switch to the app. Hide the browser console and check that it actually works. We have my material, replace it through button click. Let's do it with the rest of the buttons. This one will be for plastic. And the final button will be assigning the wood material. Save switch to the app tab and refresh. The users can now swap the materials as they wish. Let's check the animation. It works independently from the configurator. The only thing we forgot to do is to apply anisotropic filtering to the new textures, as we did in part 3. Let's also set the Clearcoat parameter to 1 for the carbon material to imitate the additional thin layer. Clearcoat is used to imitate films or polishing that cover the main layer of a material, such as carbon or wood. Let's set anisotropic filtering for the textures of the wood material as well. Now we can export and refresh our app. So, this is it with the configurator. Everything works pretty fast and looks nice. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.